say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Performing our national anthem, that was Skylar Cole. And now we'll be back in just a moment. Greetings, folks. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for our latest presentation of NBA basketball. Brian Anderson here. With me, Grant Hill and Richard Jefferson. Joining us courtside is Allie LaForce. Allie, it's all yours.
Hey, Brian. Well, after the super teams, some current top teams have been constructed more traditionally. Commissioner Adam Silver said, quote, great teams are built different ways, but when you can watch these players grow up and develop together, it's a wonderful thing to see. Brian?
A little more meaningful building from the ground up, Allie. Thank you. And a chance now to take a look at some numbers for Jaylen Brown.
And he's gone cold over the last 10 games, guys. His scoring numbers are down, and he can't seem to get out of this rough patch. He's got to get himself going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
So let's take a look at the starters for the Philadelphia 76ers. Up front, it's Tucker at the four, next to Embiid in the middle. James Harden out there with Maxey. And it's Harris in at the three slot. And for Boston, Tatum and Horford at the forward slots. Jaylen Brown is out there with Derek White. And it's Williams in at the five, down low. Well, whenever you bring up the 76ers, you instantly think of Joel Embiid.
Oh, no question. He's the face of this franchise. Embiid is as good as anyone in the league. Off the floor, Joel is willing to take the blame when things don't go right. That's who you want as a leader.
Now here's Harden. Pass to Harris. Offensive rebound. Good on the shot.
The reach of Embiid with his size and wingspan, he's a real threat on the offensive glass.
Now White. Playing Detroit, he was nearly unstoppable. And it's Tatum missing. Harris against Tatum. On the wing, Harden. Pass to Maxey. Three-pointer. It's good. Off the assist from Harden.
Meet your point guard. Harden stirs the drink for you as effectively as he scores.
Here's Tatum. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
And guys, talk about silencing the critics. Tatum made first team All-NBA last year and led the Celtics to their first finals appearance in over a decade.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for Tatum. You know, probably the biggest shift for Tatum, his advancement at the defensive end, Grant.
Oh, no question, B.A. And that's imperative at the small forward position. Think about it. You have guys like LeBron, Kawhi, KD. Now Jason Tatum is in that elite two-way group as well. And you have to put Jimmy Butler in there as well.
No good on the second free throw.
Now look, from the moment he stepped into this league, Jason Tatum has been a difference maker. Every team in the league is looking for guys like him. Long, athletic, and most importantly, winners.
Now here's Embiid. Coming off a 31-point game. And it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
And last season's scoring champion, Joel Embiid, the first center to lead the league in scoring since Big Shaq way back in the 2000 season.
Free throw drops for Embiid. And Joel Embiid, last season, the first center to average over 30 a game since Moses Malone did it back in 1982, Grant.
Oh, B.A., talk about historic company. And how about this? Also the first ever international player to lead the NBA in scoring, too. I mean, he won't be the last with the way things are.
Now, here's Williams. That one doesn't drop. Excellent D there from Embiid. Maxey passes to Harden. Embiid, a screen on White. Pass to Embiid. Let's the three fly. Yes, and a nice assist from Harden. Embiid's got 8 points.
Ideal way to start the game. Come out of the gate and knock down all but one of your first five shots.
Boston again missing.
Oh, wow. Okay, we're going to start the game with four straight misses. Look, that's about as rough as it gets. It'll get going soon.
Three-pointer, Harden. Tatum pulls it in. For Boston, they've gone 0 for 4, missing their first four attempts. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. It's hauled in by the Sixers. Embiid's got a rebound number 5 here tonight. Outside Harden. Embiid, a screen on White. Pass to Embiid. Harris on the wing. 6 on the shot clock. Over Williams. Harris misses. Boston has gone 0 for 2 from outside. It's White with a drive. Count it. Now Philadelphia with it. They're on an 11-3 run. Tucker with the ball. Outside Maxey. Inside and stolen by Williams. Harden against White. And Embiid with the block.
Love to see Embiid swatting down shots, taking advantage of his size and frame.
Harris on the wing. Tucker with a screen. Harris passes to Harden. 5 to shoot. And count that. 2 points and a chance for one more at the line. Well, when you get to the middle of the season like we are now, are you still experimenting with your game as a player, RJ?
Yeah, there's always room for improvement. One thing that I tell people is that if you start working on something at the beginning of the season, by the end of the season, it could be a part of your game. So you're just always looking to refine your skill and your craft.
Free throw off the mark from Harden. You know, only two players have won both MVP and Sixth Man of the Year honors. Bill Walton and James Harden.
What's interesting is that they won Sixth Man of the Year at very different stages. Harden was 22 and still growing as a player, while Walton was 33 at the tail end of his career for the Celtics.
To the middle. Here's Melton. Rebounded by the Celtics.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Here's Hauser. Gets the three ball to go.
Yeah, an underrated passer. Griffin wants to involve his teammates as much as he can.
Outside Milton. Pass to Melton. Launches it. It's not going to go for him. Now Boston takes it the other way. They defeated Detroit in their last game.
They were so consistent from the three-point range in that one. And that's a nice weapon to have as a visiting team.
Yeah, they just pummeled them from the perimeter. Did a nice job working the ball around and getting those high percentage looks.
The Sixers leading. 107 left to play in the first quarter. Harden, the pass to Milton. Now here's Embiid, defended by Griffin. Pass to Melton. Let's go with a three. And the three-pointer goes.
An excellent perimeter offense so far. Their shooters are clearly in a great rhythm.
Here's Hauser. Here's the three. And it's Niang with the rebound.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
Outside Harden from behind the arc. No good. And Boston going the other way now. Last time they met was right here, and they were able to come out with a win.
They beat this team last time largely because of the massive free throw disparity.
Yeah, they played a very smart and physical game, creating a lot of calls that often went their way.
Williams with the screen. Another shot. And it's Brogdon missing.
I thought he had that all sewn up, but somehow the defense just threw him off.
Joel Embiid, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for the Philadelphia 76ers. Dominating on the glass. What a quarter. More NBA on 2K Sports right after this. If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter in this one. All right, well, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the 76ers. Here's Pritchard, looking for his first basket still in this one. Well, Grant, you look at the Celtics and their defense. Not a surprise, it's at the heart of this team.
No question. I mean, you have three-plus defenders on the perimeter. Their big men can switch on the guards and protect the rim, too. Top to bottom, they can match up well with any team.
So, on the floor for Philadelphia to kick off the second quarter. Tobias Harris out there with P.J. Tucker. Then it's Montrezl Harrell. Then there's Tyrese Maxey. And it's Melton in at the point guard position. Now here's Maxey. In his last outing with 12 points. Harris, a screen on Brown. Here's Maxey. Somehow scores the layup in traffic. Maxey's got his second bucket of the night.
Love how selfless he is setting brick screens like this. Plays like that right there are what help create easy scoring opportunities.
Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Thanks, Brian. James Harden, with plenty of confidence, said, not to brag or anything, but I'm really good at this game. I'm unselfish. I play the right way. I don't try to do anything I can't do or that doesn't benefit our team. And that mindset keeps me in a good place. BA?
Very self-assured, Allie. Thank you.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
And you have to think that one advantage this Celtics team has is a deep roster. Lots of quality guys they can assemble different ways. They're pretty adaptable.
The Celtics making a switch here. White's checked in. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Thybul, he's checked in for Melton. And so Tatum nails both of them. You know, a versatile bench really is a gift for the Celtics in tough situations.
And even a great starting five isn't perfect against every opponent. It's important to have flexibility, and that's something that Boston definitely has.
They grab their own miss. Outside Maxey. No good on the triple. Boston trailing. Outside White. Pass to Williams. Outside, Brown. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity.
Well, you have to be impressed with the constant growth we're seeing from Jaylen Brown. He's put in a lot of work to become an all-star player.
What's up?
And the free throw, no good. And at this point for Brown, do you think he's realized his full potential, Richard?
No, I don't even think so, especially when you look at his work ethic. He puts in so much time that I think he can reach another level. He's still young and eager to learn. If I were to put it in 2K terms, I think he could get up to about a 94, 95 overall.
And we're going to have a jump ball. Two on the clock. Tucker, the pass to Maxey. The Sixers with another miss.
Not that time, but that's a shot that he's going to make more often times than not.
White with it. Harrell picks him up. Here's Brown. And it's Harris with the rebound. The 76ers have gotten only one of four shots to go in. Maxey against White. Maxey, that's good. Maxey's got seven.
He just makes it look so easy on offense. Like, who takes pleasure in torturing defenses? He does.
For Boston, they've got two of three shots to go in the second. Brown finds Tatum. Now White. Brown with it. Impressive scoring stats with around 27 points a game. Can't get it to fall. And for the 76ers, they're shooting at about 44% so far. Thybul passes to Harrell. To the paint. Uses the glass to finish the layup. And now a 7-point Philadelphia lead.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's three straight field goals from below the free throw line.
And for the Celtics, they're shooting poorly. Just 29% from the floor in this game. Tatum inside. Harris on him. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. That one on Harris.
It's crazy. He's growing taller. He's adding more muscle. Tatum just becomes harder to defend in there.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for Tatum. RJ, you played with some of the greats. LeBron, Duncan, Dirk, Jason Kidd, just to name a few. But if the game were on the line, who would you want taking the last shot, putting you on the spot here?
I'm going to be really honest. I have been in great situations with all of those guys, and they have all delivered. So this isn't, but I'm going to go with the person that's delivered the biggest shot of my career, and that was Kyrie Irving, and he hit the clutchest shot in NBA history. Argue with me if you want. You're going to lose it.
Yeah, no argument here. Now here's Harden. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Knicks in New York.
Putting others before himself, racking up assists. Hey, I wish I played with more guys like him.
And almost 4 minutes gone in the second quarter of play. Up top, Tatum. Coming off a 34-point game against the Pistons in Detroit.
Okay, look, when you play aggressively, you can really get to the line. Just ask him.
Now here's Harden, leading by five. Embiid, a screen on White. Here's Harden. Pass to House. And here's Embiid. Tries yet again. Griffin pulls down the board. Griffin's got his fourth rebound in this one. Tatum finds White. 1:36 left to play in the first half. Horford, a screen on Thybul. And the call will be against James Harden. That's his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Celtics. Williams has checked in for Horford. Hauser comes in for Tatum. And Pritchard is subbed in for White. The 76ers also with a sub. Melton's checked in. Embiid against Griffin. Shot clock at 6. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. They've led by as much as 10. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Knicks.
They hit a couple big shots, but overall, there was a lack of consistency. Just not their night at the offensive end.
And tonight, I expect them to play better offensively, try to get some closer looks.
Now here's Harden. Continues to make an impact on offense, putting up 21 a game. There's 45 seconds left in the second quarter. Here's Brogdon. To the inside. Williams. No good there. Philadelphia's gone 0 for 3 from deep to begin the second. Pass to Embiid. Ooh, Griffin with the steal. Down low. Here's Brogdon. Good setup. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup. Brogdon's got his second bucket on the night. Harden, the pass to Embiid. That one a little long. Here's Hauser. Brogdon from outside. And that's not gonna go. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. The Sixers on top, up by 3. Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Doc Rivers and Coach. You guys came out aggressive in the first half. What stood out to you?
You know, we're getting to the paint making plays. They're a great team as far as rotation, so we just got to make the right passes.
It all starts with attacking the basket. Thanks, Doc.
Thanks, Allie. After the break, we'll see you right back here to begin quarter number 3.
Welcome. The first half is in the books, so let's check out the top performers for each team.
Not surprising to see two competitive guys who bring it every time they're on the floor. It's been a spicy duel to watch.
Yeah, and we know you like it spicy.
No, I don't. Give me some milk.
Now moving on to the Boston Celtics and the close first half they played.
Inefficiency on the offensive end. How about pounding it more inside, like I always say? Also, if you don't have a look, don't take a crazy shot. Make an extra pass.
Shaq, it's a great recipe, man. More physical, more unselfish.
That's right. Recipe, put a little ice cream on top of that hot fudge and you get a championship like me.
Thanks for tuning in. Now it's time to head back over to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been a fairly even one. What else can you say? Joel Embiid, an impressive effort here today.
They've leaned on him to provide a lot of offense, and that's how he likes it.
He always wants to be a go-to guy for them. I'm sure he'll be calling for the ball even more in this half.
Horford and Williams together in the front court. Brown and Tatum are the explosive wing pair, and it's White in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Down to 5 on the shot clock. This for the tie! Knocks it down from distance. White's got 5 points.
They've really picked up the energy level and have willed themselves back into this game.
And as tired as they might be after fighting to tie it up, they have all the momentum now to finish this comeback.
Now here's Embiid. Give him 8 points now. And Robert Williams picks up the foul. That's foul number 2 for him.
I have to admit, I mean, it's always a tough decision for the ref on the block charge call.
And here are the Sixers now. Embiid, a screen on Tatum. Tatum with a steal.
And it's pretty simple. I mean, once you leave your feet, you leave yourself with very few options.
How about the balance from Tatum? Absorbing the contact, it just doesn't matter. He takes it like a champ. Jason Tatum, still so young. His game's still evolving. Over the last couple years, he's been getting to the line more and more, and that's huge.
Now here's Tucker. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. A moment to hear from Ali LaForce.
Well, guys, the Celtics are handing the keys to the two Jays, Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. There have been growing pains and even some question if the pair could coexist. But Brown said, quote, "The adversity will help us grow. As long as I'm on the same page with him and he's on the same page with me, we're all good." Brian?
Figuring it out, Ali. Thank you. Harden misses. And Jason Tatum seeing his free throw attempts increase. What's that tell you, Richard?
Well, it just tells me that he's playing with more intensity, but he's also playing smarter. Jason's using his athleticism to force the issue. Get to the easy points at the line. That's what your thoughts are.
And the 76ers with some changes. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Embiid. And Milton subbed in for Harden. Outside Maxey, trying to go for a lob there. Excellent defense and anticipation to stop it. To the inside, Horford uses the glass on the layup.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. You know, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Now here's Milton, providing this team some offensive stability. A little over 10 points a game. Pass to Harris. Six to shoot. Back to Milton. Can they get it? He's off on that one. And Boston going the other way now. Tatum drives in. The kick out to White. The three. The rebound by Maxey.
Shocking that he just bricked that one. The defense got real lucky there.
Pass to Milton. Harrell, a screen on White. Here's Milton. Here's Harrell. Counted and the foul. That one on White.
Yeah, terrific execution by Harrell. He collects the rebound and immediately goes after a shot of his own.
Some changes for Boston. Williams has checked in for Williams. Malcolm Brogdon comes in for Tatum. And Pritchard is subbed in for White. Niang, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Thibault comes in for Tobias Harris. Well, Richard, as a former player yourself, what's your take on stars demanding trades and jumping around the league so much?
It's tough because I've seen the other thing happen to stars. Blake Griffin re-signs with the Clippers. They show him videos of putting his jersey in the rafters, and then he's traded a year later. So I think everybody has to figure out what is best for them, but you also have to try as an individual and as a professional to fulfill your obligations. And I think trades can be someplace in the middle of that.
And you know Harrell wants to jam it. No layups here. He loves flushing it home.
So it's Boston now. Since halftime, they've only allowed 5 points. Outside, Williams. Pass to Brown. Jacks up a three. Sinks the tray. Brown's got 5.
And in the second half here, they're shooting a terrific percentage from 3.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 2 of 5 in this third quarter. And here's Milton. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. We've got 1:55 left to play in the third quarter. Out of bounds, it'll be Celtics ball. Griffin, he's checked in for Horford. House, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Melton comes in for Milton. There's 1:54 left in the third quarter. When you think of the 76ers, Richard, they've had so many Hall of Fame players.
Allen Iverson sticks out to me. Growing up, I loved watching AI play. And then when I entered into the league, I was competing against them. If you grew up in the 90s or 2000, AI was the guy that just kind of changed everything for you.
This has been a close game in a lot of ways, but they do have an edge on the boards.
Melton with the ball. Picked up by Griffin. Harrell. And the bucket counts. And he is on his way to the line. He'll try to make it a three-point play.
You know, in the past several seasons, there's been one constant with the 76ers. They're going to be among the best defensive teams in the league.
Hauser, he's checked in for Boston. Korkmaz has checked in for Philadelphia.
One shot.
And that one misses. The Sixers' identity really does center around their defense.
It's so true, B.A., and they've done a great job playing to their strengths. That's the key for any contending team. Maximize your players' talents. Philly has done that as well as anybody.
Here's House. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Here's Pritchard. Griffin outside. Shot clock at 5. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Now Melton. He's been a consistent contributor, averaging just over 11 a game. Here's Harrell. Williams grabs the board.
Well, and that's what you get when you go for style points with a fadeaway. And look, he paid the price.
Brogdon with the ball. A steady force on their offense, recording around 14 and a half a game. From deep, Melton. No good on the buzzer beater. Tie game in Boston. And when we return, we'll get the fourth quarter rolling here on 2K Sports. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And the winner today coming from an unlikely position. It's the big fella with the sweetest pass of the day.
I feel like we've seen more slick passing big man in the league today than we've ever seen.
And with three quarters behind us, we'll start the fourth in what is still anybody's ball game. On the court for Philadelphia to start the fourth. Up front, it's Tucker at the four, next to Embiid in the middle. Maxey out there with James Harden. And it's Harris in at the small forward position.
And this is just typical of him, always making an impact at crucial moments in the game.
And his team needs every bit of his production if they want to pull this one out. It is neck and neck here in the final period.
The Sixers leading. Outside Harden. Outside Tucker. For three, Maxey. Tries again. Embiid, good. Embiid's gotten four this quarter.
And his ability to efficiently score, that's really helped him out in this one, putting them ahead on the scoreboard.
Tatum passes to White. They double-team Brown. Puts up a three, and there's White. That's good on the assist from Brown.
Proving he's more than just a go-to scorer. Brown also loves swinging the ball to open teammates.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 2 of 3 to open the fourth quarter. Harris outside. Over to the left wing. Embiid inside. Williams defending. Yep, that one goes. And the 76ers lead by 3.
Can't ask for a better look with the game in the balance.
Pass to Brown. Looking to get back on track. And it's good on the lay-in.
Impressive ball handling from Tatum. Attracts the other team's focus and then finds the open man.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 3 of 4 in the fourth and looking confident on offense. Tucker with the ball. Now Embiid. And good work on the boards as they picked up the second chance points.
And they've really relied on him down the stretch.
Brown against Maxey. Brown inside. Horford for three. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got a rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Maxey with it. Now guarded by Brown. Boston's gone 1 for 3 in the fourth quarter from range. White finds Brown. Williams with the screen. They double-team Brown. Pass to White. Clock at 6. Now Brown to tie it up. And it's Harden who pulls down the rebound.
Not his best night, and not the team's best night. Sometimes it just goes that way.
Now here's Tucker. Outside Harden. Takes the 3. Yes, and it's Embiid picking up the assist.
You gotta chase Harden off that 3-point line. He is too good of a shooter to be given any airspace from that line.
Tatum from long range. The rebound by Embiid. Embiid's got rebound number 11. White against Harden. Harris outside. Out to the right wing. Embiid inside. Working on Williams. Oh, it's blocked by Williams. Left side, Tatum. Pass to Horford. Fires for 3. Philadelphia grabs the miss. They've led by as much as 10. Here's Harden. 1:46 left to play in the fourth quarter. To the left side wing. Embiid passes to Tucker. Leans from outside. Brown with some nice D.
He made that way more difficult than it had to be with that leaning jumper. As a result, he comes away empty.
Outside Tatum. To stop the drought. The rebound by Embiid. Embiid's got rebound number 12 here already in the game. Maxey with a screen on Williams. Here's Embiid. Good. 8 buckets in 12 attempts.
Yeah, Embiid is getting everything he wants on the offensive side. He's playing some aggressive basketball right now.
Here's Tatum. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to go. The 76ers making a switch here. Melton's checked in. That's good. Going 1 of 2 from the line. And that narrows the gap to 7.
Hope that leaving points at the line won't come back to haunt them.
Pass to Harden. 43 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Nice D from Tatum.
Things aren't looking good here. I mean, they need points and they need them now.
And if I were them, I'd start thinking about where I'm going to get food after the game because this one looks a bit out of reach.
Now here's Harden. Embiid, a screen on Brown. Harden, the pass to Embiid. Back to Harden. To the paint. And the lob disrupted. Not to be. Oh, a deep 3 from Tatum. And here's Brown for 3. That one no good. Outside Harden. So this one belongs to the 76ers. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them. They had to dig deep to come out on top.
Yeah, you know, some teams might buckle under the pressure towards the end. The crowd was so amped up, such a hostile environment. But they stood tall and got the win.
Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Guys, thanks so much. PJ, congrats on the win. What do you think was the biggest factor for you guys tonight?
Defense is pretty good this whole game. Everybody stuck to our principles. And more than anything, we just play hard. We play hard as crap tonight.
Keeping it simple. Thanks, PJ.
Allie, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. This is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching as New Balance presents our player of the game, Joel Embiid.